Okay, now we will see the high pressure mercury vapor lamp. The working of the mercury vapor discharge lamp mainly depends upon the pressure, voltage and temperature, other characteristics. So that influences spectral quality and efficiency of the lamp. There is a three type of mercury vapor lamp, high pressure mercury vapor lamp. One is MA type, another one is MAT type, another one is MB type. This is in the 250 to 400 range, and then MAT lamp is the 300 to 500 watt range, and then MB type is 80 to 125 watt, and then it is working at a very high pressures. Okay, we'll see first the MA type lamp. It is a high pressure mercury vapor discharge lamp that is similar to construction of sodium vapor lamp. Okay, we can see here there is a long inner discharge tube, and then the outer tube, and then electrode, argon gas. Okay, many things are there. Okay, you will learn one by one. MA type lamp consists of a long discharge tube in U shape and is made up of hot glass or quartz. This discharge tube is enclosed in an outer tube of ordinary glass. To prevent the heat loss from the inner bulb by convection, the gap between the two tubes is completely evacuated. Inner tube contains two main electrodes and an auxiliary starting electrode, which is connected through a high resistance of about 5 kilo ohm. It is also contains a small quantity of argon gas and mercury. Two main electrodes are tungsten coils coated with the electron emitting material like thorium metal. Here we can see that there is two tube, one is inner tube, another one is long U-tube, discharge U-shaped tube. Okay, that long tube is made up of hot glass or quartz. In that it is enclosed by a outer tube. Okay, that is a ordinary glass. And then for preventing the heat loss from the inner bulb, there is the gap that is fully evacuated, means there is no any gas. Okay, that is fully evacuated. And then the inner tube is having the main two electrodes and then auxiliary starting electrode that is connected to the high resistance about 50 kilo ohm, and then it is also having the small amount of argon gas. Okay, so here we can see this is the vacuum space, and then here argon gas, and then there is auxiliary electrode, and then there is a main electrode. Okay, this is connected to the resistance. Okay, now we will see the working. Initially the tube is cold, and hence the mercury is in condensed form. Initially when supply given to the lamp, argon gas present between the main and auxiliary electrodes gets ionized. So first the thing is argon gas will be gets ionized, and an arc is established, and then the discharge takes place through the argon for few minutes between the main and auxiliary electrodes. Then what will happen? As a result, discharge takes place through argon for few minutes between the main and the auxiliary electrodes. The discharge can be controlled by using high resistance that is inserted in series with the auxiliary electrode. So when it is a supply given, so the argon gas is ionized and then the discharge takes place for few minutes between the main and axillary electrodes. And then for controlling the this discharge, we can use the high resistance, which is already connected in series with the axillary electrode. After few minutes, the argon gas as a whole gets ionized between the two main electrodes. The discharge shifts from the axillary electrode to the two main electrodes. So initially the discharge takes place between the main electrode and the axillary electrode. After that, it is happening between the two main electrodes. During the discharge process, heat is produced, and this heat is sufficient to vaporize the mercury. So here, mercury vapor lamp, high pressure mercury vapor lamp, we need to vaporize the mercury, but before that, what is happening? That argon gas, that is vaporizing. As a result, the pressure inside the discharge tube becomes high, and the voltage drop across the two main electrodes will increase from 20 to 150 volts. After 5 to 7 minutes, the lamp starts and gives its full output. Initially, the discharge through the argon is pale blue glow, and the discharge through the mercury vapors is greenish blue light. So initially it is like pale blue or greenish blue. Here choke is provided to limit the high current, and capacitor is to improve the power factor, as we have seen already. The supply is interrupted, the lamp must cool down, and the vapor pressure must be reduced before it will start. It takes approximately 3 to 4 minutes. The operating temperature of the inner discharge tubes about 600 degree centigrade. The efficiency of this type of lamp is 30 to 40 lumens per watt. These lamps are manufactured in 250 and 400 watt ratings for use of 200 to 250 volt on AC supply. Okay, this is generally used for general industry lighting for ports and shopping centers and railway yards. So here we should notice the values: 600 degree temperature, and then 250 and 400 watt ratings. And then if it is shut down, it will take three to four minutes. And then the efficiency is 30 to 40 lumens. Okay. Now we will see the MJT type lamp. This is another type of mercury vapor lamp. It's manufactured in 300 and 500 watt rating for use on AC as well as DC supplies. The construction of the metal lamp is similar to the MA type lamp, except the outer tube being empty. It consists of the tungsten filament, so that at the time of starting, it works as a tungsten filament lamp. Here the filament itself acts as a choke or ballast to limit the high currents to safer value. When the supply is switched on, it works as a tungsten filament lamp. So initially it is working like tungsten filament. Its full output is given by the outer tube. At this time, the temperature of the inner discharge tube increases gradually. The argon gas present in it starts ionizing in the discharge tube at any particular temperature is attained. Then the thermal switch gets opened, and the part of the filament is detached, and the voltage across the discharge tube increases. Now the discharge takes place through the mercury vapor. Useful color effect can be obtained by this lamp. This is because of the combination of the light emitted from the filament and blue radiations from the discharge tubes. In this type of lamp, a capacitor is not required, since overall power factor of lamp is 0.95. This is because of the filament itself acts as a resistance. So here we should notice the thing. One outer tube is there, that is empty, and then there is a tungsten filament. At the time of starting, it is working like a tungsten filament lamp. And the filament itself, it is act like a choker ballast to limit the high current. When supply switched on, it worked like a tungsten filament lamp, and then it slowly the full output will be given by the outer tube. So slowly the temperature also will increase gradually as the argon gas is starting ionizing. So that in this lamp the resistance is there, so that you will get a good 0.95 overall power factor. So no need of any capacitor. So this is the MAT type lamp. So here filament is there, and then inner discharge tube, and then this is the outer tube, and then here there is two for the terminal is given. This is the MV type lamp. Okay, this we are going to see in coming slides. Here initially it will look like a filament tungsten lamp. Slowly it will increase the heat, and then it will start glow as the argon gas starts ionizing. This is MB type lamp. It is also similar to MA type lamp. Inner discharge tube for MB type lamp is about 5 cm long, and it is made up of quartz material. Made up of quartz material. It has 3 electrodes, 2 main and 1 axillary. There are 3 electrodes. Yeah, that is one is main, 2 is main, and 1 is axillary. Here very high pressure is maintained inside the discharge tube, and then about 5 to 10 times greater than the atmospheric pressure. So this is a very high pressure maintained discharge tube. The outer tube is made with a PAL glass material so as to withstand high temperatures. So we can use those tubes in any position because they are made up of the special glass materials. The working principle of MB type lamp is similar to MA type lamp. These lamps are manufactured in 300 and 500 watt rating for use in AC as well as DC supplies. An MB type lamp consists of bayonet cap with 3 pins. So there will be three pins. It may not be used in ordinary sense. A choke coil and capacitor are necessary for working of this type of lamps. Now we will see the fluorescent lamp. Fluorescent lamp, day to day life, in our life we are seeing that. This is the another one method of gases discharge lamps. This is the low pressure mercury vapor lamp. Actually we saw the high pressure mercury vapor lamp. In that only we saw the three type: MA type, MAT type, MB type. In that we have two electrodes and the axillary electrodes, like that we saw that. Now we see the fluorescent lamp. In this we use the coated material. Okay, we'll see one by one. Fluorescent lamp is not a cathode low pressure mercury vapor lamp. Fluorescent lamp is a hot cathode low pressure mercury vapor lamp. The construction and the working will be explained down. So in construction, it consists of a long horizontal tube. Due to low pressure maintained inside of the bulb, it is made in the form of a long tube. The tube consists of the two spiral tungsten electrode coated with the electron emissive material and are placed at the two edges of the long tube. So in the tube there is a two spiral tungsten electrode in the two edges. The tube contains small quantity of argon gas and certain amount of mercury. So in that tube argon gas also there, and then mercury also there at a pressure of 2.5 mm of mercury. Normally, low pressure mercury vapor lamps suffer from low efficiency and they produce an objectionable colored light. Such drawback is overcome by coating the inside of the tube with a fluorescent powders. They are in the form of solids. Okay, as already we saw that. That is known as phosphors. Okay, so this is the fluorescent lamp. Here, this is a tube. In the tube, we use the mercury and argon gases. And then here, two filament is there. Here, we have the one starter and then one capacitor. And then it is connected through the choke. And then in this tube inside, there is a phosphor coating. A glow starter switch contains a small quantity of argon gas having a small cathode glow lamp. Yes, inside that starter there is a small cathode glow lamp with a bimetallic strip. It is connected in series with the electrodes, which puts the electrodes directly across the supply at the time of starting. And then the choke is connected in series that acts like as a ballast, acts as ballast when the lamp is running, and it provides a voltage impulse for starting. So the initial high voltage it is given with a choke, and a capacitor of a 4 microfarad is connected across the starter in order to improve the power factor. So this is the fluorescent lamp, the outlook and structure. So here a capacitor and then starter and then choke, then the fluorescent tube with it, and we are using. Okay, we will see how it is working. At the time of starting, when both the lamp and the glow starters are cold, the mercury is in the form of globules. But when supply switched on, the glow starter terminals are open, circuited, and full supply voltages appeared across the terminals. Due to low resistance of electrodes and choke coil. Here the resistance of the electrode is low and the choke coil resistance is low. So glow starter terminals is open circuited, and then the full voltage will be given to the terminals. The small quantity of argon gas gets ionized, which establishes an arc with a starting glow. This glow warms up the bimetallic strip, thus glow starts get short circuited. So first the argon gets ionized, and then the arc will be established, and then it will start glow, and it will warm up, and the bimetallic strips that glow starts gets short circuited. So this bimetallic strips will be in the starter. Initially it will be in open, and then after that it will be gets short circuited. Hence the two electrodes come in series and are connected in across the supply voltage. Now the electrodes get heated and start emitting electrons due to the flow of current through them. So here the starter initially open, and after argon gets ionized and the arc established, and then it warms up. Due to the heat, the bimetallic strips it will making the circuit, the starter short circuit. After that, the electrode will be in the two connected into two series, that will be connected across the supply voltage, and then the electrode will be get heated and start emitting the electrons. Okay, and then these electrons collide with the argon atoms. These electrons collide with the argon atoms in the long tube. That takes place through the argon gas. So in the beginning, lamp starts conduction with argon gas, at the temperature increases, the mercury changes into vapor. Okay, as we seen in the last lamps, mercury high pressure vapor lamp, same like that here also, argon lamp, argon gas first it is starts conducting, then temperature increases, the mercury changes into vapor, and then it is takes over the conduction of current. In the meantime, the starter potential reaches to zero and the pyrometric strip gets cooling down. As a result, the starter terminals will open. This results the breaking of the series circuit. A very high voltage around 1000 volt is induced because of the sudden opening starter terminals in this series circuit. So what will happen? The starter potential reach the reach to zero and then cooling down, then it will open. So here very high voltage will be induced in the series circuit because of the sudden opening of the starter terminals. But in long tube, the electrons are already present. This induced voltage is quite sufficient to break down the long gap. Thus, the more number of electrons collide with argon and mercury vapor atoms. So there is the collision of the electrons and the argon mercury vapor atoms. It is very important. The excited atom of the mercury gives UV radiation, which will not fall in a visible region, which means the mercury vapor atoms, the excited atoms will give the UV radiation. Okay, this we have to keep note. Okay, the excited atoms of the mercury will give the UV radiation. Then this UV rays is strike in the phosphor material that causes the re-emission of the light of a different wavelength, it producing the illumination. The phenomenon of the emission is called luminescence. That is a two way, one is fluorescence, another one is phosphorescence. In fluorescence, the excitation will be only for excited periods. Phosphorescence, it will even after exciting source removed also, the excitation will be present. Here the different phosphorus materials are given. Zinc silicate, calcium tungstate, and then magnesium tungstate, cadmium silicate, zinc beryllium silicate, cadmium borate. These are the color effects: green, bluish white, yellowish pink. So different phosphorus material will give the different color effect. Okay, cadmium and the zinc beryllium silicate, it is giving the yellowish pink, and then cadmium borate, it is giving the pink color, and then zinc silicate is giving the green, calcium tungstate give the green, magnesium tungstate giving the bluish white color. So the re-emission of the light causes fluorescence. That lamp is called a fluorescent lamp. It has some advantages. That is high efficiency. The life of lamp is 3 times of the ordinary filament lamp. The quality of the light obtained is much superior because of less chances of glare, and these lamps can be mounted on the low ceiling where other light source would be unsatisfactory. And then some disadvantages are there. Its initial cost is high because of the choke and starter. The starting time as well as the light output of the lamp will increases because of the low ambient temperature. This fluorescent tube also, the starting time and the light output, full output, that time that will increase because of the low ambient temperature. Because of the hot, because of the presence of the choke, these lamps will suffer from magnetic humming and may cause disturbance. Sometimes we may feel the different noise because of this magnetic humming. And then the stroboscopic effect of this lamp also is objectionable. These are the reference J.B. Gupta Utilization of Electrical Power and Electric Traction SK Comparisons as per the Arthur's Utilization of Electrical Energy, Tanpatrayan 4. Thank you.